In this video, I'm going to talk about 6.2, Skill 2, recognition of the chambers and valves of the heart and the blood vessels connected to it in dissected hearts or in the diagram of heart structure. So here we are going to consider the diagram of the heart structure. So first, we are going to see how to find or identify the left and the right side of the heart. So here, our right is going to be the left side of the heart. And the left side of the heart deals with oxygenated blood. It receives oxygenated blood and it pumps it to all parts of the body. The other side is the right side. The right side deals with deoxygenated blood. So it receives deoxygenated blood and pumps it to the lungs for oxygenation. Next, now let us identify the chambers of the heart. So heart has four chambers. It has two upper chambers and two lower chambers. So here one and two are upper chambers. These upper chambers are called as atrium or auricle. So we have right atrium and left atrium. Next are the lower chambers. So three and four here are the lower chambers, which are called ventricles. So we have the right ventricle and the left ventricle. Now the upper chambers can be identified by having thin walls as compared to the lower chambers. And in the lower chamber, the left side has a thicker wall as compared to the right side. Now upper chambers are all receiving chambers, whereas the lower chambers are the ones which pump blood out of the heart. So these are pumping chambers, whereas upper ones are the receiving chambers. Now next, let us identify the blood vessels. Now the blood vessels 1 and 2 are the ones that carry blood away from the heart. So any vessel that carries blood away from the heart is called as an artery. Now here we have in blue 1, 2 and 3. These are the blood vessels that carry blood to the heart, or it brings blood to the heart. These are called as veins. The first one here, the artery, is the aorta, which carries to all parts of the body. Then the next is pulmonary artery, which carries to the lungs. We have superior and inferior vena cava that brings blood from the body parts, and pulmonary veins that brings blood from the lungs. Next, we identify the valves. Now the heart has four valves here. This one and two, these are between the auricle and the ventricle, so they are called atrioventricular valves. The atrioventricular valves on the right is called tricuspid, and on the left is called as bicuspid. Apart from that, there are two other valves which we call as the semilunar valves. The semilunar valve on the right side is called as a pulmonary semilunar valve, as it is at the base of the pulmonary artery. On the left side, it's called as the aortic semilunar valve, as it is at the base of the aorta. Now, let us label the parts of the heart. So, all the labelings here now. We begin with the aorta. Then, next we see the structure here, that is the pulmonary artery. This is the left atrium. And then we label the pulmonary veins. The pulmonary veins bring oxygenated blood from the lungs to the left atrium. This is the aortic semilunar valve, which is at the base of the aorta. Next, this is the atrioventricular valve on the left side. So left atrioventricular valve, that is called as a bicuspid valve. The next is the chamber. This chamber is the left ventricle, which contains the oxygenated blood that is pumped out of the heart to the body parts. This is the septum that separates the right and the left ventricles. Next, we start with labeling the vena cava. So we have the superior vena cava at the top here. Then the chamber, that is the right atrium. Next, this is the inferior vena cava, which brings deoxygenated blood from the lower parts of the body. This is the pulmonary semilunar valve. The pulmonary semilunar valve is at the base of the pulmonary artery. On the right side of the heart, between the atrium and the ventricle, is the tricuspid, that is the right atrioventricular valve. And finally, the right ventricle. With this, we complete the labeling of the heart.